to have him come out, Fred Redmond, who's from the International Union of United Steelworkers, before I bring Arlen out. And I want to tell you, Fred understands the seriousness of this issue. And we're going to have two workers speak a little bit later in the program that have faced some adversity. Fred lives with this every day all over North America in reference to standing up for freedom of workers. I'm so honored to be a member of the United Steelworkers. I'm even more honored to stand on stage with a great humanitarian, my brother, Fred Redmond, for the United Steelworkers.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I first want to bring you greetings on behalf of my international president, Leo Gerard, who unfortunately couldn't be with us this morning, but he's here with us in spirit. I also want to welcome to the great Union City of Pittsburgh all the members of the Democratic Party of the state of Pennsylvania. It's important that we recognize our good friends in the Democratic Party, because the Democratic Party and organized labor have a very unique, strong history. We have stood together bonded at the hip, standing up with each other on behalf of working family issues, built on a sincere principle that America works best when we have a strong and vibrant middle class.
Yeah, right.
It was the Democratic Party who stood up with us when we brought together to the table issues of workers' safety and health and helped us create OSHA. It was the Democratic Party who stood up with us and helped us create minimum wage laws throughout this country. It was the Democratic Party when the labor movement and the civil rights movement got together and spoke up on behalf of disenfranchised people in this country and got the Civil Rights Act passed. So let's not be conflicted. Let's not get confused. We are here this morning because it is time in history that we come together, our unique coalition, on behalf of the millions of workers throughout this country who are asking for a voice in their workplace without the threats and the intimidations of their employer. We are here for them. And we need every Democrat, not most of them, we need every Democrat, and our friends on the Republican side of the aisle that have conscience to understand that in this country, workers should have the right to self-determination. Workers should have the right to freely choose whether or not they want to work. We are here because we are the voice of those workers. And there's no more critical issue before organized labor now to make sure that those workers' voices are heard. And their voices will be heard when we pass the Employee Free Choice Act. So once again, it is time for the Democratic Party, it is time for organized labor to stand up on behalf of workers and do the thing that's morally right by passing the Employee Free Choice Act. Thank you very much.